'Cause I bet it's lying. I don't care if it's Chinatown or on Riverside. I don't have any reason. I left this war behind. I'm in a New York state of mind.
How can you not be impressed with SUNY after you've seen a video like that? Boy, what a crowd we've got. I guess you really got something important to say today. They all showed up. Yes. Good morning, and welcome on behalf of the State University of New York Board of Trustees to the fourth annual State of the University Address. As you can see on the screen and in this audience, I am joined by the incredible group of people that make up the SUNY board, and I would like to have them stand so you can acknowledge them and the leadership they provide. Would my colleagues please stand? Thank you. Thank you. This is an exciting day, and I want to begin by thanking the elected officials who joined us today. In particular, I'd like to thank Lieutenant Governor Bob Duffy, who you will hear from in just a few minutes. We are so grateful for the Lieutenant Governor's support across the entire SUNY system. He truly understands the value of our colleges and universities in every region of the state, as we are honored to have him in our corner. He's always been there for us. I also want to personally thank Chancellor Zimpher for her vision and dedication to making the State University of New York a world-class institution that brings innovation ideas to scale. During her time as the leader of SUNY, we have been recognized for the strides we've made through our strategic plan, The Power of SUNY, and I can think of no better partner as we move forward into 2014. Last week, we heard from Governor Cuomo on the state of the state, and once again, SUNY is a prominent collaborator in many of the state's initiatives. At the system level and at individual campuses around the region, around the 10 regions of New York State, we are moving the dial in academic excellence, workforce and community development, and community revitalization. We have had an amazing year with big accomplishments and tough challenges, some of which you will hear about today from the Chancellor. But through it all, I know I speak for all my colleagues on the board when I say that at the forefront of our minds during deliberations, we are always concerned about the people we serve, the students, the faculty, the staff, and all the stakeholders who make up our SUNY family. This morning, the Chancellor and I had an opportunity to have breakfast with the new president of ACT, the Association of Community of College Trustees, the new leader, Angela Henry. And I was so struck by the immense commitment of the time and energy that these individuals, these trustees, these leaders of our campuses, the way they work throughout the SUNY system to carry forward our important mission. We truly appreciate the input and advice that results from the in-depth dialogue that we have with the trustees, and it is my pleasure to work with them every day. And today, I have the added bonus of actually introducing a particular trustee. In June 2013, we welcomed Trustee Tremayne Price to the SUNY Board of Trustees as the new student representative. Since joining the board, Trey has contributed on behalf of the students. He's been their advocate in terms of helping us to focus on academic affairs, research, economic development, communication, and community colleges. Trey also serves as the president of the SUNY Student Assembly, an organization that is the voice of the 465,000 students across our campuses, where he collaborates with students to promote their success while at the State University. Trey received his bachelor's degree from the University of Albany, and he is currently enrolled in the school's Educational Administration and Policy Studies Master's Program. Without any further discussion and adulation, I would like to present Trustee Trey Price.
Thank you, Chairman McCall. Good morning, and once again, welcome to the 2014 State of the University Address. My name is Tremayne Price. I currently serve as a member of the Board of Trustees and as President of the Student Assembly. But more importantly, I am also a proud alum and current graduate student at the University at Albany. The State of the University Address provides us with a unique opportunity to not only reflect upon the previous year's accomplishments, but to get a glimpse into the future through the strategic and innovative vision of our Chancellor, a glimpse into the power of SUNY. As we listen to SUNY's agenda for the year ahead, it is important that we all keep in mind one of the most critical components of the power of SUNY, It's 465,000 students. Students and their success are at the heart of all that SUNY is and all that SUNY does. As such, SUNY remains committed to its mission of providing a quality, affordable higher education and continued access to students regardless of their race, class, or gender. These principles have been exemplified in many of SUNY's initiatives throughout the past year, a few of which I would like to briefly mention this morning. The first of which is the SUNY Smart Track Initiative. SUNY was the first higher education system in the country to make a concerted effort to educate students and their families about the cost of a SUNY education and help them plan financially for the future, which ultimately increases students' chances to remain in school and earn a degree. SUNY's also made great strides in the area of student mobility. Through state-of-the-art degree planning software tools for students and their advisors, campuses will be able to provide students seeking transfer better information about their progress toward degree completion and improve planning services for all SUNY students with the hope of increasing degree completion rates and lowering the time to degree. Lastly, through SUNY Works, students are provided with cooperative education and internship opportunities that allow students to connect what they are learning in the classroom to real-world experiences and making them more likely to graduate and be prepared to enter the 21st century workforce. Through such initiatives, SUNY is able to impact the lives of its students and give them the tools that they need to help them explore their endless potential and the various pathways available to them, ultimately leading them to meaningful careers as effective citizens in this new globalized economy. All these great initiatives would not be possible without one of SUNY's greatest champions, Lieutenant Governor Bob Duffy. It is through his efforts and those of Governor Andrew Cuomo that SUNY benefits from such landmark legislation as NY SUNY 2020, which allows our campuses modest tuition increases to add more faculty, educate additional students, increase class offerings, and ultimately improve graduation rates. The tuition plan also brings stability to a history of unpredictable and often dramatic change in tuition over the years, thus allowing students and their families to better plan for college expenses. Having graduated with 2 degrees from Monroe Community College, he is a shining example. He is a shining example of the power of SUNY. I am very proud to introduce you to our Lieutenant Governor, Robert J. Duffy.
Thank you. Well, first of all, on behalf of Governor Cuomo, it is an honor and privilege to be here today for the Chancellor's SUNY State of the University Address. It really is, and I've had the pleasure of being at the State of the State last week, and today is an equal pleasure. I'm going to start by making some acknowledgments here, first to Carl McCall, who is the chairman of the SUNY Board of Trustees. I've been a big fan of Carl McCall for many years, going back to his previous careers. It is great to have somebody of Carl's stature and leadership at the helm here with the Board of Trustees. I want to thank him personally for his leadership and thank him for all he's done for SUNY. So, Carl, thank you. To Trey Price, I just made a little note. Never follow Trey Price in speaking. I said on stage earlier, I said, Trey, you're in trouble. You have 2 great recruiters, the governor and a chancellor. So this young man is going to stay in New York State. But I just want to thank Trey for his introduction. I want to thank him for his very kind words. And to me, Trey Price epitomizes what we want. And we want these incredibly young, bright, gifted men and women who graduate by universities to stay here and stay in New York State. And I know he will. Trey, I will take a resume back with me today, too. So you're not going anywhere. You're staying here. And to our great chancellor, I'm going to get to in a moment, I just want to say how blessed we are to have Nancy Zimpher at the helm of SUNY. And I'm going to introduce her momentarily, but I just want to publicly thank her time and time again for what she has done. First of all, very briefly, in my job, I get to go around the state. I think I've been on every one of the campuses represented here or nearby in the last 3 years. I've had the pleasure of seeing what happens on the ground. It's been said by Carl McCall and by Trey, but one of the things I want to repeat, SUNY is a world-class institution. It truly is. It's a world-class institution because of its leadership from the chancellor to board of trustees to the presidents, to the faculty and the students. You have made this university system world-class, and I would say across this country and across the globe, it would be difficult to beat the talent that we have here. It's not just about education. You are really driving the governor's main economic development goals. When I look at SUNY's role, a great role in the regional councils, there are many presidents here today who are, and other people have been represented on the regional councils across the state, driving the economy. That has been terrific. You are a big part of education, providing low-cost, affordable, but high-quality education across the state repeatedly. That has been terrific. You are a big part of training our workforce for the future. The economy is changing. The world is changing. And to keep up with that economic change, we need young men and women who have the skills when they come out of school to fill those roles for these jobs. And that's what you are doing time and time again. And you're training doctors and nurses and specialists in the medical field. You have a role, really, all the way around our state. And again, it's not just about educating these great, talented young men and women. It is about creating jobs. And you've had a huge impact on the quality of life across our state. And I can tell you from my travels, I have seen it. I have witnessed it. I am very proud. I appreciate the acknowledgement from Monroe Community College and President Kress and all the team from MCC. I'm a proud SUNY graduate, and SUNY provided me with an opportunity and a great education. At that time, I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do with my life. And I look back, I've never forgotten what Monroe Community College did for me, and I know what SUNY does for young men and women like me and others around this state. You deserve really a great round of applause and thanks. I want to thank you personally for what you've done. And now we get to the most important part. Leadership sometimes is hard to describe in words, but very easy to see. And I could use a lot of words, but I get to work for a great leader with Governor Cuomo, and I get to work alongside and see a great leader in Chancellor Zimpher. And ladies and gentlemen, I have witnessed a chancellor from her first entry into the state and what she has done. She is a phenomenal leader. She is strong, she is principled, she is visionary. She has taken sometimes big ideas that are put forth in the state and put those into concrete steps and actions and results across New York State. The state of SUNY would not be where it is today without this incredible woman. And I just want to say, on behalf of all of us across the state, on behalf of Governor Cuomo and everybody across New York State, we owe her a great debt of gratitude because she has taken an already great institution and moved the ball in this great SUNY system down the field and raised the level and raised the bar time and time again. And I think that really goes with leadership. Leadership does matter. It matters in everything that we do. And you could not have a better leader than Chancellor Nancy Zimpher. So please, I'd ask you to stand up and give the great chancellor of the great SUNY system of state of New York a warm welcome. Nancy Zimpher.
I said to Lieutenant Governor Bob Duffy personally, as soon as I saw him get off the elevator, you just don't know what a thrill it is for us to have you here. You are representing your own role and what you have done across the state for our regional economic development councils, for our campuses, and for the citizens of New York. And I know, too, that you are here with the governor's blessing, and what great partners we have in Lieutenant Governor Bob Duffy and in Governor Andrew Cuomo. So thank you on behalf of all of us. So thank you. Thank you. And let me add my welcome to the State of the University address for 2014. I loved the video. I hope you did. Every year they outdo themselves. The production team that's in the house today, because you're going to see some other videos and a PowerPoint and a lot of bells and whistles, they are just top-notch. So I want to thank you guys, wherever you are, for your work in making this possible. I like the song, "The Best Days," of so many of our students and alums at the State University of New York, and Trey epitomizes exactly what our work is all about. To you, Chairman McCall, I couldn't have a better partner. I love to walk through the State House with Chairman McCall because there's simply no one in the state of New York who doesn't know him. And I get to meet a lot of people that way. And his leadership on our very extraordinary SUNY Board of Trustees is exceptional. Trustees, I'm thrilled to have you here. We are having our board meeting concurrent with the state of the university address, and it's working wonderfully, and I'm thrilled to have you here right in the front rows We are, of course, blessed by so many wonderful people, our campus presidents who line the front ranks of this hall, our students, our faculty, our staff, our alumni, distinguished guests. There are a number of elected officials in the House and fellow New Yorkers. We all have an enormous role to play in advancing the state of New York and the State University of New York. So I really want to thank you, one and all. It just means everything to have you in the House today. While there are a lot of moving parts in my annual State of the University address, and sometimes you say too many parts, today I really want to stress three major points. How the power of SUNY is paying off for New Yorkers, how our ambitious goals are fueling innovation at scale, and how translating systemness into collective action will drive our work in 2014. So stick with me. I think this morning is going to be an exciting ride. I've said 20 people have their hands on these remarks and only one gets to deliver, but know that this has been a team effort all the way. Most of you helped launch the power of SUNY, that big, hairy, audacious goal for SUNY and for New York that we knew could drive the state's economic resurgence, create jobs, and educate more smart, skilled, and confident graduates to fill those jobs and enhance the quality of life for every New Yorker. We began thinking and acting beyond our campus walls, forging stronger partnerships with school districts, business, industry, and government in an effort to get SUNY working at its highest potential, to be, as we've said many times, greater than the sum of our parts, to leverage our systemness, and in the process, help New York State realize its own capacity for collective impact. Together, standing on the shoulders of those who came before us, we ran with the theory, and what emerged were six big ideas that have positioned SUNY to help solve New York's greatest challenges. These commitments have anchored our actions ever since. Recall the entrepreneurial century where Tim Killeen's leadership at SUNY's Research Foundation is defining New York's innovation ecosystem, as he calls it. Not only has our massive research portfolio resulted in breakthrough discoveries and inventions and startups, we are witnessing an unprecedented level of collaboration between SUNY students, faculty, and industry experts to enable commercialization at scale. What does this kind of growth mean for New York? Facts don't lie. Our campuses are the workhorses of intellectual property. And in 2013, together, we produced 59 patents, 218 invention disclosures, and over $8.8 million in royalties across the system. I think, Tim, that is the innovation ecosystem right here in front of us. And now look at how we're creating a seamless education pipeline for New York. SUNY is now supporting 11 community partnerships statewide to help youth as they prepare for college and career based on highly successful proof points from Cincinnati to Seattle. We are learning how to collectively support all students every step of the way. And now we've created the New York State Cradle to Career Alliance, so we are poised to significantly move the education dial in the years to come. And of course, SUNY's Energy Smart New York initiative is driving more energy efficiencies. A recent standout example is Upstate Medical's Geneva Tower renovation. We saw a picture of it yesterday in the board meeting. Transformed an abandoned high-rise residence into an internationally recognized green building. And by the way, joining the multitude of SUNY buildings designed for LEED certification. And then, of course, the idea of the healthier New York. SUNY remains committed to tobacco-free campuses, and we will continue to work with the sponsors of our legislation to seek successful passage. And in the meantime, we are continuing to design and implement strategies to drive campuses toward the tobacco-free goal. And of course, we have a commitment to what's called vibrant communities, which I think no doubt contributed to The announcement last week by U.S. Vice President Joe Biden and Governor Cuomo, the development of a new college dedicated solely to emergency response after the destruction and devastation of Hurricane Sandy. And through big idea number 6, SUNY in the World, we expanded our partnership with the New York Academy of Sciences and joined its Global STEM Alliance. We're working with Argentina, Malaysia, Barcelona, and Cisco Technologies to bring academic resources, intergenerational mentorship, and cutting-edge science and technology to students around the world. With all this great work, we need to note that we are not going it alone. With the passage of NY SUNY 2020, SUNY found its champion in Governor Cuomo, embarking on what has been perhaps the most valuable and productive state government partnership in SUNY's history. And I want to tell you, Lieutenant Governor, everywhere I speak across the country, I talk about a partnership with this state that I believe is like no other, another opportunity to say thank you, New York, for taking up the cause of SUNY as an asset to this great state. This was landmark legislation. As Trey said, predictable revenues enabled by rational tuition and maintenance of effort, a promise from the state combined with our own careful, award-winning master planning by the SUNY Construction Fund, we have channeled $1.5 billion in the last fiscal year to rehab, to renovate, and build anew our aging campus facilities. On many campuses, 2013 was an exciting time, breaking ground for new facilities. Take a look at what happened at Potsdam.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again?
Do you ever feel
so paper thin, like a house of cards, a blow from caving in?
Investment and SUNY has also boosted the confidence of our donors, resulting in recent record levels of philanthropic contributions. 35 campuses are now poised to do even more in the coming year with the launch of new fundraising campaigns. Together, we will again top $300 million in donations across the system in 2014. In addition, we remain on target to reach our goal of at least $100 million in savings as a result of shared services. Near the end of the second year, we've already reached the halfway mark, and those savings are being plowed back into academic services and faculty growth. Also in recent years, SUNY has sharpened its focus on remediation, on seamless transfer, and on completion. And toward this end, SUNY is making real progress. We are, as Trey alluded to, we are implementing a number of strategies. Every one of our campuses, for instance, is now registered to participate in this National Student Achievement Measure. It's going to be called SAM. Some of you may know that we've been worried about how we calculate graduation rates. We think this is going to be a more accurate system, and it is going to show that SUNY's degree completion rate is really much higher than previously thought, which is very good news for the state of New York. I'm also proud to say that in 2013, SUNY adopted the most comprehensive policy in seamless transfer in the country. In service to nearly 30,000 students who transfer across the SUNY campuses every year. We didn't just address the transfer of a few subjects, something that many of our peers have done. No, we adopted a policy that assured the seamless transfer to all campuses of every single course approved for SUNY's 30-credit Gen Ed requirement and selected major courses. More than 400 faculty were involved in the initial development of our 38 transfer paths, and now more than 1,100 faculty are engaged in finalizing this outstanding accomplishment. I could only say on behalf of everybody, thank you, faculty, for your leadership in seamless transfer. Give them a round of applause. They work hard. Further, since this is a pipeline endeavor, SUNY's statewide network of 23 early college high schools now enrolls over 5,000 students from every background and in some of the state's most challenged zip codes. Add to SUNY's early college high schools 14 emerging PTEC high schools, and we are creating success stories all over the state. The average graduation rate for our early college high school students is 84%. The state's rate, 74%. So we are beating that calculus. Last year as well, as Trey mentioned, we answered President Obama's clarion call for increased affordability and transparency. We've launched the SUNY Smart Track campaign. Today, all of our campuses, 2 and 4 year alike, are now using a clear and standardized financial aid award letter, probably the second envelope to be opened on that video. Now prospective SUNY students and their families can calculate the cost of college to the penny and plan accordingly. No other system in the country can say that. And I think this is the way the phrase goes, inquiring minds are noticing. To underscore SUNY's excellent bang for the buck, just last week, Kiplinger ranked 9 SUNY schools as top values in public higher education nationally. So I want to congratulate Stony Brook, New Paltz, UB, Oneonta, Purchase, Fredonia, Plattsburgh, Geneseo, and Binghamton for cracking the top 20 among some very stiff world-class competition. So thank you. So, as we are wont to do, we packaged 2013 for you. SUNY has its collective act together. The even better news is that SUNY has set a breakthrough set of strategies that will achieve career success.
The largest comprehensive university system in this country.
Setting an example for other colleges in the nation, SUNY Chancellor Nancy Zimpher.
Local university ranked in the top 10 when it comes to the lowest student loan debt in this country.
Binghamton University ranks near the top in most affordable schools in the country.
Treat when it comes to low loan debt for its graduates.
Makes a promise most business owners would jump at.
Investing in the SUNY system, SUNY 2020.
The No Tax Pledge extends to employees of qualifying companies.
Startup New York establishes tax-free zones on and around SUNY campuses.
To link our student interests with the job demands of the state.
We're open to whatever possibilities are there for us to make a contribution.
Buffalo's hoping to lure more high-tech business.
It's not only is this a model for New York, I think it's going to be a model for the country.
A team from SUNY ESF is on the cusp of a major breakthrough.
Hillary Clinton received a resounding standing ovation as she walked on stage to speak at UB's Alumni Arena.
Some pollution problems in Lake Erie tonight, a major research effort by SUNY Fredonia.
The new program will allow high-achieving students to graduate with a liberal arts degree in only 1 year.
Of Delta Printer. This is a brand new 3D printer that's coming out on
to worse hurricane damage. And those are the more fundamental problems.
Listen to this, guys. Researchers at the University of Buffalo are trying to develop a Wi-Fi network that can work underwater.
Hopes the technology will improve tsunami detection, natural gas exploration.
Security department at SUNY Broome is ensuring a happy holiday season for those serving overseas.
New York!
We're promoting science, technology, engineering, and math, and we're really trying to encourage STEM mentoring.
Each student had a job upon graduation.
Kudos.
It featured the daughters of Archbishop Desmond Tutu.
The University of Buffalo, the president on his first stop in a two-day stop.
Introduce you now, the president of the United States, Barack Obama.
Hello, Buffalo.
Hello, Binghamton.
I'm excited because of the great work that SUNY campuses like Binghamton are doing to keep costs down for hardworking students.
Zimpher says getting more well-educated graduates into the working world is the only way to dig ourselves out of the tough economy.
Could allow it to compete on a global level.
The future of our country depends on people like you who have been educated and prepared to be change agents in this world.
Just like, you know, Chancellor Zimpher and the folks at SUNY are trying to step up and lead the way to do the right thing for students.
Thank you.
So, it's easy to see why President Obama came to SUNY to outline his vision for the future of higher education in America. And the president is right. We are doing great things here that should be emulated in every state. We are good, but we can be even better. And it helps to have friends in high places that are pushing us to do even more. In June, Governor Cuomo unveiled Startup New York. This initiative, like no other in the nation in its scale and innovative use of university, industry, government partnerships, designates our SUNY campuses as tax-free zones for new and expanding businesses. Nowhere in the world do businesses and communities stand to benefit more by partnering with higher education than here in New York, a mighty hub of innovation, diversity, and skilled human capital. Take a look.
SUNY is home to big ideas, and now we are embarking on one of the biggest in our history. Leveraging our position as New York's premier driver of economic activity, SUNY now stands at the nexus of one of the most transformative pro-business and pro-education initiatives in the country, Governor Andrew Cuomo's Startup New York. Through tax-free zones at SUNY schools, this unique economic development plan brings academia and business together like never before, creating an entrepreneurial 21st century college campus. It means unprecedented opportunities for our students, researchers, innovators, and most of all, it means jobs for New Yorkers all across the state. SUNY's intellectual capital and our unmatched programmatic diversity opens the door to companies of all sizes, long-standing or just getting off the ground, in every sector and every region. The possibilities are endless, and so is the benefit to SUNY and the communities we call home. SUNY scientists working with their private sector counterparts, moving ideas from the lab to the market. Students getting real-world experience with not only a job once they graduate, but a reason to stay, live, work, raise a family, and prosper right here in New York. Startup means innovation. It means discovery. It means a new chapter for SUNY and for New York.
To fulfill Startup New York's full promise, we are transforming how we manage enrollment to create and expand degree programs that meet these new high-need employment areas. In partnership with the State Departments of Labor and Economic Development, we are using state employment data to determine New York's workforce needs. Last year alone, we awarded 36 campuses more than $12 million to meet regional workforce demands in engineering, healthcare, renewable energy, agriculture, and IT. In the true spirit of systemness, all 30 of our community colleges came together last year in an unprecedented collaboration to also address workforce needs statewide. So with the support of our New York congressional delegation and in partnership with more than 150 employers and professional associations, SUNY is using this federal grant to prepare thousands of students for careers in high-demand advanced manufacturing, participating with global foundries, IBM, and GE, and other companies that have gladly made the commitment to SUNY that our students will be first in line for their new job openings. We have recognized as well that ensuring a pipeline of highly qualified high school grads requires highly qualified teachers. Hand in hand, again, with Governor Cuomo, we have raised our academic admission standards for our teacher education programs to 3.0, and we are serving as the backbone for New York's Master Teacher Program, providing incentives to keep New York's best teachers in the state's classrooms. As I have said repeatedly, we prepare the teachers who prepare the students who come to college. Ready or not, we own this challenge. The initiatives I've highlighted so far make a compelling case for how SUNY is, in fact, driving New York's economy and quality of life. And at SUNY, that's what we're all about, meeting challenges head on. Like the projection that New York will need at least 1 million more new bachelor's degrees earned by 2025 to meet workforce demand. But how do we do this on a scale large enough to truly make a difference? How do we provide unprecedented access to SUNY's high-quality, affordable education? I am so glad you asked. I am beyond excited today to lay out for you a massive endeavor, one that, without a doubt, embodies all of the ideals we have embraced over the past few years. In 2012, we opened the door to online learning. Then last year, we set an ambitious agenda to expand access to an additional 100,000 students in the next 3 years. Now, with the development of an innovative learning platform, we can combine the vast access provided by online education, the capacity for completion only possible because of the size and depth of our academic support systems, and a clear path towards success for our students and our state in building a competitive workforce. Today, we introduce Open SUNY.
SUNY Delhi has been successful at online education because of a variety of factors. We have a strong enrollment services department, an advisement program, and tremendous faculty.
I think what makes Open SUNY different from what other campus or systems are doing is the sheer size and magnitude of Open SUNY. This is the first time that students will have access to resources through all 64 of our campuses under the umbrella of Open SUNY, making it significantly easier for students to find and locate, you know, courses that they might need or just might be interested in taking.
Online education for me will put me in the running with the other people applying for these jobs that I know I can do. I need to be able to fit my education into my life, not fit my life around my education.
Being able to tailor a course to meet the interests of different learning styles is one of the great advantages of bringing technology to any type of instruction. We're excited about Open SUNY, again, as I mentioned earlier, because it gives us a chance to leverage our, you know, small to medium-sized college resources with the vast reach and international brand of SUNY.
Thank you. So, I know you know this, but online education is arguably the hottest topic of the day. But I want to be clear, this isn't about SUNY being trendy. It is about making sure New Yorkers have the educational opportunities they need to be successful in the 21st century economy. And it's no small task. Today, 6.9 million New Yorkers have a high school degree but no college education. Meanwhile, by 2025, 60% of the job opportunities will require at least a bachelor's degree, so we have got a lot of ground to make up, and that's where online education can step in. To be the nation's leading online learning experience, in true SUNY fashion, we pulled together 300 stakeholders from every campus to develop this vision. We call this our digital DNA, and it's all about strong student supports, the best in academic programming, campus and system level infrastructure, and perhaps, and of course, most importantly, a vibrant network of expert and committed faculty. The good news is We didn't have to start from scratch. SUNY is already a power player in online education. Today, 85,000 SUNY students are enrolled in 12,000 online courses taught by 7,000 SUNY faculty with more than 150 fully online and incredibly high-quality degree programs. In fact, last week, U.S. News and World Report included 7 SUNY campuses among the best in the online business, ranking SUNY Delhi number 1 in the nation. But we know New York has untapped potential, people with real commitments and constraints, jobs, children, aging parents, financial limitations, community ties, very real factors that limit access to traditional higher education. So we are going to bring access to them by harnessing new technologies. In essence, Open SUNY will allow us to reach everyone on their own terms. And this increased anytime access will mean that students won't be shut out of classes they need to graduate. And by vastly increasing access in this way, we are speeding completion, which is clearly an effective way to cut college costs. So today, we are launching 8 online programs offered by 6 of our campuses that we are calling Open SUNY Plus, meaning they carry unique features that go beyond our existing online programs. They are aligned with New York's workforce needs. They are filled with applied learning opportunities, riveted on student completion, taught by extraordinary faculty, and even more affordable. So these new Open SUNY Plus programs, new in that they carry this massive support system, are going to be in the areas of applied science in clinical laboratory technologies, business management and economics, science, mathematics and technology, tourism management, electrical engineering, nursing, business administration, and health services administration. 6 presidents stepped up to deliver these 8 Open SUNY Plus programs. Please stand, President, so we can thank you.
Thank you.
So this is just the immediate future of Open SUNY, the today future of Open SUNY, but we plan to increase the number of degree programs and courses, and we will continue to grow exponentially in the years to come so that we can meet that anticipated service to mostly adults in New York to the number of 100,000 additional students to the State University of New York. We have created Open SUNY Center for Online Teaching Excellence. Our faculty can join a professional development community and hone their skills. For faculty looking to push the edge of the envelope, the Open SUNY Scale-Up Lab will provide an outlet to experiment with and pilot innovative learning practices. And Open SUNY will be supported by a student concierge, a 24/7 help desk with tutoring, mentoring, and degree planning, and advisement services as well as financial aid information. We will also engage in recruiting more students focused on that $6.9 million undereducated adult New York population. And together with our stakeholders and with careful review, technological enablers, and faculty engagement, we will build or adapt offerings beyond the programs announced today, like a gen ed package, like industry recognized specialized and laboratory certificates, and more, because Open SUNY's support of our academic offerings is absolutely unlimited. Because of our system's diversity, our reach, our scope, open.suny.edu could become the nation's largest, most extensive distance learning environment today. And that's news. The new academic delivery models like Open SUNY have, however, ignited a debate. In spite of, or even because of, these kinds of developments, some critics think that there's a cheapening of higher education. Noted in The Atlantic, critics are raising the alarm that speeding up college and making it cheaper risks dumbing it down. I take issue, of course, with this kind of criticism, and so does New York Times journalist Frank Bruni. I loved this quote. I think it epitomizes where we are. We're in a tricky, troubling spot at a time when our nation's ability to tackle complicated policy problems is seriously in doubt. We must pull off a delicate balancing act. We must make college practical, but not excessively so. Lower in price without lowering its standards, and increase the number of diplomas attained without diminishing not only their currency in the job market, but also the fitness of the country's workforce. Frank got it right, and we know it. It's SUNY's responsibility to make the most of these technologies, to push the limits of what they can do to better serve our students in our state. This means experimentation, it means pioneering, it means trying new things, and it means ensuring the enhanced quality of everything we do, and at SUNY, that's what we're all about. So where do we go from here? I think it's fair to say we've learned a lot from our Open SUNY experience because we're doing it together, we're doing it with data to support our decision making, we're doing it at scale, and because we're ensuring quality by making strategic investments in what works. In short, our systemness looks a lot like collective impact. That idea that genuine change requires disciplined action by dedicated partners who are willing to work together to solve problems. In other words, moving from 1,000 points of light to concentrated engines of coordinated, coherent interventions to drive change. Our progress is proof positive that only a focused and united effort will generate the kind of reform New York and even this country needs to remain a global leader in education. So 2014 will be all about renewing and furthering SUNY's commitment to New Yorkers and doing so on the shoulders of our strong, innovative partnerships that span the state and are attracting national attention. I want to give you a few examples as we used to say, round third and head for home. First, we're going to turn the lens on ourselves and revisit the plan that brought us this far. As we enter the fifth year since the launch of the Power of SUNY, we will take a fresh look at this plan they do have a sense of humor, to assess the quality of our performance and the depth of our impact over the next 5 years, ending by 2020, hitting even more ambitious targets. We think this is exactly the kind of transparency called for in President Obama's scorecard initiative. Second, I want to talk about SUNY Works, a program that encompasses internships, clinical experiences, and cooperative education opportunities offered by our campuses in partnership with the state's employers. SUNY Oswego and FIT are leading campuses partnering with some of New York's foremost employers. But let's go further. Our goal is to have every student have an applied learning experience by graduation. It won't be a requirement because it doesn't need to be. We know that the vast majority of our students will want to participate. Already over 50,000 students are. Our goal remains an applied learning experience for every SUNY student.
Tough job market, and without experience, it's hard to find a position right out of college anywhere.
I've been working for 2 months, and I've learned so much more than I could ever thought.
What Co-op allows you to do is take the questions and topics that you learned in school and find out how they apply to the real world.
I'm going to stay on a project-by-project basis, but it seems, again, like an opportunity I can't pass up.
We treat our co-ops as employees. We really plug them right into the team. They have responsibilities within the groups.
The people that we've had join us are technically excellent. They are highly marketable and will be very relevant in the marketplace, and they've been a tremendous asset to us.
Students returning from professional experience enrich the classroom by bringing that experience to the classroom.
Employers benefit from co-op relationships because we're able to fill gaps in our staffing challenges.
I strongly encourage my students to consider cooperative experience because it enabled them to see how the things that they're learning in college will apply directly in a job.
In my case, I was fortunate enough in that I was offered a full-time position after my appointment.
I think one of the best benefits to co-ops is that they make connections with people who work in the industry that they would like to work in.
Indeed. So this is why in 2014, to promote the expansion of SUNY's successful cooperative education and paid internship initiative, I will personally engage the CEOs of every Fortune 500 company in New York and other large employers with the goal of 100% participation in SUNY Works. We will form a co-op task force comprised of business leaders from across the state focused on expanding SUNY Works and supporting Governor Cuomo's Startup New York Economic Development Plan. Third, the SUNY Networks of Excellence, introduced this year with a $4 million commitment from the Research Foundation, represents SUNY's capacity for collaboration at its best.
The Networks of Excellence are SUNY's way to activate, if you like, the magnificent brain trust we have across the various campuses in areas of research that are important for society, for where we have substantial capabilities.
Across SUNY, we have so much assets, in terms of, again, our intellectual assets and our infrastructure, that we need to bring these together.
It's our network faculty and students from across our SUNY campuses that are doing the heavy lifting and coming up with interdisciplinary and transformative ideas.
I think this is an exciting time. We have the support from the state, from SUNY, to bring together scientists and engineers that normally would not interact.
Collaborations between Buffalo and Albany and Stony Brook could create jobs located at all three positions that didn't exist there before.
These networks get access to collaborators and facilities at other SUNY campuses, to the two-year community college students at the very beginning of their college education.
I think it's an ambitious approach to creating new knowledge and having SUNY really drive that.
So in four high-demand areas, our networks are bringing together SUNY's top scholars and industry experts to spur research and commercialization. This is in energy, healthcare, neuroscience, and manufacturing, and a fifth to be launched this year in the arts and humanities. So going forward, we will measure outcomes achieved by each network and additionally invest at least $1 million more per network this year to support workshops and collaboration and proposal development for external funding. Fourth, to make sure every student in New York finishes high school ready to succeed in college, we need to double down on our commitment to steadily decrease the need for remediation. I mentioned earlier the very important work that our early college high schools are doing, but we need to attack the stubborn reliance on remediation from multiple angles. We need to better communicate to high school students the academic skills they need to do college-level math and English. We need to incentivize these high school students to take more math by offering college credit for their fourth year of math. And we need a universal diagnostic taken by students in the 10th grade to assess their pathway toward college readiness, and that might just be the PSAT if we could make it universal. Fifth, there's no denying the importance of the STEM disciplines in today's global economy, and that's why SUNY's efforts to support STEM are directly linked to our teacher education and workforce development programs. In his State of the State address, Governor Cuomo proposed providing full tuition scholarships to the top 10% of high school graduates if they pursue a STEM career at a SUNY campus and then work in New York for the next 5 years. Beginning this year, and in continued partnership with Governor Cuomo, the State Education Department, and school districts across the state, SUNY will introduce incentives for students who choose teaching careers in the STEM fields as well. And finally, while we are calling for unprecedented access to our colleges and universities across New York through programs such as Open SUNY, we must ensure that SUNY continues to reflect the unique diversity of New York among our students, our faculty, and administrative bodies. Therefore, I'm naming a special task force to propose ways to improve the diversity of our SUNY family. Our goal is, yes, to catch up with the diversity of this great state and then, of course, surpass it. So that's the road ahead. Before I let you go, here's a line I've been replaying lately. It's not the strongest of the species that survived, nor the most intelligent, but the one most responsive to change. Contributing comment to Charles Darwin is common, but wrong. It was actually spoken by a man named Leon Meginson, an expert not in biology, but in management. So here's SUNY's greatest advantage. Because not only are we strengthening our system, not only are we creating breakthrough new ideas and technology, we are also pushing outward in every direction, every day, to adapt to the needs of a changing world. This is the evolution of education in action. This is the delicate balancing act. Systems and institutions learning to become leaner, smarter, stronger, and more resourceful through the very kind of hard work that SUNY is leading, and this is innovation at scale. And that's why our dynamic great system was created more than 60 years ago, to give everyone a chance to better themselves, their lives, their families' lives, and their communities through education. So now I want to talk directly to you. Our experienced Lieutenant Governor today is joined by brand new mayor of the city of Albany, and I want to recognize Kathy Sheehan, our partner in this great capital district. So, to the Lieutenant Governor and to the mayor, here's what we're really, really about. If you are a student at SUNY right now, just stand and stay standing. And I know there are some of you in the house. If you are teaching as a faculty member, as an adjunct at a SUNY campus right now, will you join the students and stand? If you are leading one of our great campuses as a president or an academic leader, will you stand and join our students and our faculty? I want the Lieutenant Governor to get on his feet, Kathy Sheehan to get on her feet. There are other elected officials in the House. I want you to stand. And now I want the chairman of our Board of Trustees and the magnificent trustees that the governor has appointed, and all board members and council members of our community colleges and state-operated campuses to stand. And if you aren't standing with them, stand up now. Today, with your help, with your ingenuity, with your talents, your energy, and your vision, and your drive, SUNY is breaking all the old boundaries to give every New Yorker access to the opportunities they need to develop the skills and knowledge to build a better life. There is simply nothing like SUNY anywhere else in the world. This, you are the power of SUNY, still and always. Thank you.
Let's go. Let's dance it now. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now. Let's go. Your time is running out. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now. It's not about what you've done, it's about what you do. It's all about where you're going, no matter where you've been.
Thank you very much for attending. This concludes our program.